recap video time for the overall trip to Asia. 11 videos in that series. There were supposed to be 12. We'll get to that a little bit later. So this will be the 12th video, kind of recapping everything. Cards got a little bit out of order. I was having issues similar to what I mentioned before. It's on this Mooney, for example, you see here. That's moisture right there. I've talked about this in videos before. Some cards, no matter what I do, no matter how many times I take them out, wipe them down, sleeve them, re-sleeve them, some cards, it'll just stay there. It's not always the case, but I'm wondering, so I'm using these sleeves, been using these for a while, I'm wondering if I need to switch sleeves, go with something else, go with a different brand. Now, I doubt that's really the issue. It's, I don't know, the humidity? I don't know, I just cannot figure it out on some of these cards. Also wondering if maybe I should do a little something like clean the card surface instead of just using the microfiber, if I should use Windex, something else. I mean, it's, over and over, it just keeps happening on some cards. Not all, of course, but Chrome, of course. So here's the overall review. The time I'm shooting this, I'm actually posting videos in the series. So hopefully you all are enjoying those or have enjoyed them, seeing the sights more than anything. 11 videos, like I said, all of the products cost me $340. Keep that in mind as I'm going through this and doing the recap. In the first video, now these ones were actually in order, Twin Lagoon just picked out some of the better stuff. He's a defensive player. I know. ATN, hit a few Najis, several Trey Lance, several Mac Jones. These might be the cards that are ideal for sending off to Calm C or something, putting them together as a lot. If you're trying to nickel and dime, who's trying to nickel and dime in the hobby? Now we get to the fire. Kellen Mond, times two, it gets better. Zach Wilson, times two, but wait, times three, and times three, baby. All of that action came out of a blaster and a fat pack. These cards came out of an OTE blaster. Couple Thompsons, those were the only cards really worth mentioning out of there. Both him, not one of his brother, Amen, out of a Prism cello, and Wagner, couple rookies, a little Prism Trey Man action, and the Kuminga was the best card to come out of there, out of the bonus pack, obviously. Now, as I go on with this recap, I'll be working in some video footage of some of my favorite moments. If you watched all of the videos before this, see if you can figure out what my favorite moment was. A special moment shared. We'll get to that later in the video. In videos 4, 5, and 6, we did Bowman, or blasters, or megas. So this is all of the stuff out of Bowman. So two blasters and two megas. B-roll will be worked in, of course. Two blasters, two megas. This is what you're seeing here. Some non-first action there. Got some first paper. Rookies. Duran. Whenever you see him, you're going to see Muller and Strider as well. We'll insert action here. Chromes, Sweeney, Wood, Montgomery, the newest Indian, Kiros, Sawinski, Bernabell, Marcelo Mojo. I like that action shot there. Rafaela Mojo, Bowman in 3D, Julio, hit a Mojo Julio, Mojo Bobby Witt. A little color action here. Mendez, first paper. This bum who's not even playing anymore. Velasquez, he's the guy I've actually been buying a lot of, or trying to, but his price is kind of like with what happened with Darren Baker before, and I've talked about this. People figured it out, and his prices are going too high. Well, don't make me cry. Hit it to 250, Diego Velasquez Chrome, auto Eddie's Leonard, and the best two cards value-wise, Ellie Paper and an Ellie Chrome. In videos 3 and 5, I did some 2023 Bowman blasters. This is the fruit out of there. Less, of course, the Spencer Jones redemption, which I sold for $170. After fees, probably netted about $150. Hit a couple Jacob Berries, O'Ray. Here are your Lunars. Some Chrome action. Clifford was just traded, so he's been getting a lot of buzz. This old guy that stunk. Riley Green rookie. And then some paper rookies here. Let's buzz through those. Most of the names are here. Casas, Gunner, and Bale. In video number 8, I opened a Prism blaster at Gwangjang Market in Seoul. If you recall from that video, you saw a little rudeness happen, but then politeness happened for not calling them out. Bouchel, times two, baby. Devonta Smith, and then hit that nice Jamar Chase. napkin patch. Video number 9 was this 2022-2023 Upper Deck Mega out of Series 2 at Namsan Park, Seoul Tower. Welcome to Columbus, Lunchbox Legends there, some rookie class, Clark, McBain, Kuzmenko, Instant Impressions, Dracidal, Canvas, now I know Eric, these are a nice hits, Patrick Lane, Shalgren, and thanks for the advice as always, definitely appreciate it. Like I said, I defer to the pros when it comes to that stuff. Attard, Quinn, Galvis, and our young guns, Schooneman, Gunther. And last but not least out of the enjoyable trip, and this is where something happened. Video number 10 was some of this garbage pail action, and then video number 12 was going to be the final video in the series. Shot it, deleted it. It was the whole point of going on the trip was to get a video of whatever the product was. I had to go with Garbage Pail Kids. Went with a hanger on that one because it was kind of a rough shooting condition, but when I was envisioning the trip beforehand, that was the whole point, was to get a video done there. So one of the Mrs. Favorites, Trish Squish, Dry Guy, Armpit Brit, also one of her favorites, and this is part of our If Your Lady Looks Like This series, you might want to have a talk with her, Amazing Grace, Bushy Bernice, Bushy's okay in some places, but not like that, Mardi Gras. It is ma'am. So if your lady looks like that, or Blue Boy George, it is ma'am. Have a talk with her. If she loves you, she'll make changes. Nat Nerd, Goat from the movie, like I talked about in that video. Mouth Phil, one of my favorites just because it's baseball related. And Chrome Chris, which unfortunately has that top shirt. Have to perhaps use that to rub out bad mojo out of some future openings. So what happened with that video that I was talking about, supposed to be video number 12, was I deleted it. It was glorious. It was in the Philippines. It was in a jeepney. Shot a video in a jeepney. How do you delete that footage? How do you delete it? It was actually the second to last day before we were leaving, and I have no idea how I deleted it. It was out of an app where I'm shooting this called Double Take. So once you delete the videos, they're gone forever. It's not like if you shot it on your phone where you could retrieve it. So that's the series, everyone. 11 videos, that's the recap. Keep in mind, you didn't see the Spencer Jones in this recap because I've sold it already. 150 net on that one, which raises a question. I was thinking about this when one of my Discord boys, Jamie, was talking about how he opened a Chrome Hobby and he sold one of his numbered cards for $125. So it got me to thinking about things. I know we'd ideally like to be able to rip and then find a card or two or a few cards in there that we can sell to recover our costs, keep some other things possibly for grading or just for our personal collections. But how often does that happen, right? It seems like if that's the case, given the prices of things now and the prices of singles, that oftentimes unless you're grading, then it's really a losing proposition. So grading's the key to things. And I'm stating the obvious here, of course, but again, this is just a different form of playing the lottery. Speaking of which, Mega Millions is up to $1.25 billion. At least they're projecting that for Friday, a couple days before I'm shooting this video. So I need to get me some of those tickets. Next video series, it's already been shot. Haven't edited it yet. It's Zion. Bunch of stuff going on there. I need to go shoot the recap video for that. And what I was going to say was if you do something like this, try to shoot the recap video right when you're done with it, because it was a mess trying to get this stuff reorganized. That's why some of the stuff was combined and not individually for each video. So thanks for watching, everybody. Take care. Be well.